morning, good afternoon, and good evening, and welcome to Razza Plays the Ezio Trilogy. Last episode, we left off with, we've just left, oh, bugger, what's the place called? Fuck. Florence, that's where we left off. Yeah, we've just left Florence, and, we are heading to Montenegrione. I can't say it right now. I will eventually be reacquainted with the pronunciation of that word. So, without further ado, let's begin.
We should be close.
Grazie a Dio.
Let's go.
Buongiorno, Ezio. How could you leave a Firenze without saying a proper goodbye?
Ezio!
What do you want, Vieri?
So many things. A larger palazzo, two new steeds, a prettier bride. Oh, and yes, your life.
You bastardi.
Condolences for the loss of your father and brothers.
What will happen now? There's no one left to help you. I have such wonderful things in store for your mother and sister.
I grow tired of this game. Finish him, and do not spare the women. What sorcery is this?
Not sorcery, boy. Skill.
Show yourself.
As you wish. Here, use this.
Kill them! Kill them all!
Bastard, I wanted the last kill.
You have my thanks.
Keep the sword, Ezio.
Do I know you from somewhere?
Don't you recognize me? It's a me, Mario!
Uncle Mario?
It's been too long.
Hey, look! Guess what? Where's Luigi?
I heard what happened in Firenze. Terrible. Come, let's get you all away from here.
Okay, so
tell me everything.
They executed father for treason. Federico and Petruccio too. And they came for me.
Do you know why?
I have no answers, uncle. Only a list of names taken from a man who wished me dead. I still can't believe they are gone.
Don't worry. We will make sense of this.
I wish I shared your optimism.
Come on, keep pace. We're almost there. I think you will find much to like in Monteriggioni.
I thought Monteriggioni was an enemy of Firenze.
For now. Next year it will be its friend, the year after its enemy again, and on and on. I cannot keep track, so I have stopped trying. These are honest, hard-working people. Our shops may only carry simple goods, but they're well made and dependable. There is a chapel here too. The apprentice seems a nice enough fellow, but I've never been much of a believer.
Did you know the Villa Auditore is almost 200 years old? It was built by my great-grandfather, a strange man who carried all kinds of secrets. Keep your eyes open, and you might discover a few of them yourself.
With all the fighting that's been going on, this place has started to get a bit rough around the edges. I wish I could do something about it, but I just don't have the time or money to fix things up. Guess that's life, huh? Here we are. Casa Dolce Casa. So, what do you think?
It's most impressive, Uncle.
She's seen better days, I suppose. Believe me, I'd have her shining again if only I had the time. Now that you have had the tour, Nipote, you should go and outfit yourself. My men in the market are expecting you. Return here when you're finished, and we'll begin.
Begin? Begin what?
I thought you'd come here to train.
No, Uncle. I came here to escape Firenze, and I intend to take my family further still.
But what about your father? He'd want you to finish his work.
What work? My father was a banker.
Wait, he did not tell you?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Makeme Kombini, Giovanni. Where to even begin? Go and fetch the gear in the market. It will give me time to think.
But
that's that. We'll talk more later.
Some spending money should you need it. And if you find yourself in need of rest, I've prepared a room for you on the top floor of the villa.
Well, that was nice. I got the penthouse suite. 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 Leather greaves. Small weapons. I have a dagger. Nothing better than a dagger.
There you go, sir. Mention me to your amici.
Hey, look, I have more health. Visit the doctor. Oh, doctor's inside.
And wounded.
Heal apocryptic supplies, medicine. Yay, more.
You should feel better now, but take care in future.
Da-da-da-da-da. How can I take care? I want to kill everyone. Everyone who was involved with the murder of my family. They will not have their life spared. They will die at the hands of Ezio Auditore da Firenze. But that was the name and the town I was given at birth. Let's talk to Claudia.
Don't worry. We're only staying here for a little while.
I don't like it here. I want to go home.
I know.
What's home? We have no home. Oh, look! What a beautiful library.
Salute, Uncle. I did as you asked.
And quickly, too. Ben fatto.
Now, well done.
Let's teach you how to fight.
No. As I said, we are leaving.
Ezio! You barely held your own against Vieri. You won't survive a week on the road. If you want to leave, so be it. But at least do so armed with the skills and knowledge necessary to defend yourself. If not for me, for your mother and sister.
Fine.
Thank you, Uncle. You speak with so much optimism. Don't have to fight from Mario. Oh my God!
You can swing
He's
a
such a herpaderp.
Sure, but offense alone will not carry a battle. You must survive long enough to strike.
I will teach you how to dodge.
You said my father was more than just a banker.
No use dancing around it, I suppose. Your father was an assassin, Ezio.
I told you before. My father was a paper pusher.
And a pen pusher, but not an assassin.
He was born and bred to kill.
I will be born and bred to kill.
I find this difficult to believe.
What of the list you carry? Do you think it's merely a catalogue of deaths? It holds the names of those responsible for your father's murder.
I never saw that list. I can't remember. I actually forgot about this. Quick step. Step.
I've taught you how to avoid your enemy's attacks. Now you'll learn how to turn them to your advantage.
Okay, advantage time.
All this talk of assassins and Templars, it reeks of fantasy.
Like something from an old parchment covered in arcane writing, perhaps?
How did you know?
You have your father's blade. I think that you have the codex page as well.
Aha! I want to escape this prison.
Sai, le armi servono a duellare. È un duello, fesso. Are you afraid?
Thank you.
You're making fine progress, Ezio. Today I'm going to teach you how to position yourself in battle. Where you stand and how you move can make all the difference.
Okay.
Don't think I haven't seen you picking apart my library. I trust you believe me now?
Yes. My father was an assassin. But why the need for such secrecy?
Are you familiar with the Templars? One of several knightly orders formed during the Crusades. History teaches they were disbanded nearly 200 years ago in France. Only they weren't. Merely pushed underground. Where they continue.
I get to defeat my uncle.
Hurry up and die! I'm getting thirsty. Into your own.
Thank you, Uncle.
For all you have given me.
Your family. Such is my duty and my desire.
I'm glad you had me stay.
Good. You've reconsidered leaving.
We sail for Spain in 3 days.
But Nipote, I have given you these skills that you might be better prepared to strike against our enemies.
And if they find me, I will.
You want to leave Ezio? To throw away everything your father fought and died for? To deny your heritage? Fine. Come voi. Arrivederci e buona fortuna.
Uncle, wait. Why is he so upset?
How can he not be? Vieri's been harassing us ever since you first arrived. To be expected, I suppose. Given his heritage.
Let's go see Uncle Mario. Why couldn't they have called my dad Luigi? It would have been so much more sense. Then you could call it the Mario Brothers.
Where is everyone?
They ride for San Gimignano to slay that snake, Vieri.
I wish to join them.
You'll find what you need at the stables.
Let's go check on Mother. I am getting better at the free running.
Ezio, look at her. I still can't get her to talk. She spends all day and night in front of those feathers that Lucio used to collect. She can't let them go. I don't know what to do.
Don't worry. She'll come back to us. I know it.
She will. When I collect all these bloody feathers. I have more feathers to collect, please, cause it's all about these. And I'm gonna attack Vieri de Pazzi with my sword. Come and fetch your sword, sword, with my brother. Time to kill that Patsy bastard. Nope, wrong way. I always get lost in Montenegro. That place. This place where I'm at. Okay. Aha, found it. I'm riding my horse. Have you seen? Look at my horse. My horse is amazing. Give it a lick. It tastes like some raisins. I'm actually watching this for looking. This is the first time I've played the game in HDMI. Okay, so look at my horse. My horse is amazing. Give it a lick. Oh, it tastes like raisins. Look at my horse is amazing. Give it a lick. Yep, goodbye, my friend. Goodbye, my lover. Ha ha! Oh.
Ezio, what are you doing here?
Taking responsibility. Vieri troubles you because of me.
Vieri troubles us because he's a Templar, and we are assassins.
Either way, I wish to help.
Va bene. Then listen close. First, we must find a way inside the city, though it seems Vieri expects us. He has sealed the gates and sent his men to guard them. Fortunately for us, the city is larger than his host. The southern gate suffers for it. So this is where we'll strike. Pronti?
I'm ready. It's night. Follow Mario. Follow. Are you a plumber or a mercenary? I don't understand. Running around in circles.
All right, Ezio. Here's how it is going to work. My men and I will distract the guards. Once we have engaged them, get yourself over the wall and find a way to open the gate. Take these throwing knives. Use them to dispatch the archers.
I'm ready when you are.
Then let us begin.
Climb the ramparts. I will get that. Weapons? Thank you. You're dead.
Got it! Got him off! Damn it! Where is he? There he is! Pezzo di eccolo! There! There!
He's dead. Lever. What do you get for being a douche?
I want you to distract those guards and keep them from raising the alarm. Hopefully it will buy me enough time to find and silence Vieri.
Va bene.
Wait, Nipote. Take a few of my men with you, just to be safe. Come join me once they're dealt with.
What's Vieri up to now?
Kill the guards.
But something has him on edge. How else to explain all the patrols?
I signal again when you should follow.
That's so inherent, sir.
Did you say Piccolo? Run, Forrest, run! Ezio. Come on, Ezio, you can run.
Ezio! Your uncle's under attack and needs help. Go to him!
Ah, Nipote, there you are. It seems my plan is in something of a snap. Here is men ambushed. Now we've got our hands full. My brothers and I, if you would be. Who's on that snake? The Jaffa.
You're dead. Okay, so everyone saw that. Hey, I'm sorry. That's your stuff. Come on. You can do this. I seem to be definitely getting better at my free running. Climbing. Where are you?
It's settled. Vieri, you will remain here to coordinate the mercenary. Francesco will organize our forces in the city and send word when it's time to strike. Jacopo, Your job is to calm the citizens once the deed is done.
What of that Ubriacone Mario? He continues to harass my forces, and I fear he'll discover what we intend.
He's always been trouble, just like that bastardo brother of his.
Then let me reunite them, father.
There will be plenty of time to clean up the refuti when we're finished. Now, is there anything else? Muy bien. May the Father of Understanding guide you.
May the Father of Understanding guide you.
Comandante! Comandante!
What?
Mario Auditore has invaded the city. He comes for you.
Then let's not keep him waiting.
Okay, so no one has seen the white guy. Okay, taking the shortcut. So yeah, there's a random white guy running through a battlefield. It's not suspicious at all.
Laggiù, stop! After him, ragazzi!
No. Bloody trees! That's how it's done, guys.
What are you and your allies planning? Is this what my father discovered? Is this why he was killed?
I'm sorry. Were you hoping for a confession?
Pezzo di merda! Vorrei solo che avessi sofferto di più! Hai avuto la fine che meritavi! Spero che
Enough, Ezio! Show some respect.
Respect? After all that's happened, do you think he would have shown either of us such kindness?
You are not Vieri. Do not become him. Che la morte ti dia le pace che cercavi. Requiesca in pace.
Wow, he's a fool.
Read it when you have the time. Our work here is finished. Let us return to the villa.
Wow, that was beautiful. You spin me right round, baby, right round. Video time, but I'm just keep running. Punch. Punch. I'm going to run home.
I've great metal work here.
Climbing.
And here he is,
Our campione, Ezio.
Oh, hail Ezio!
I see you've wasted no time starting the celebration.
And why not? You've done us a great service, Nipote. With Vieri dead, La Toscana will grow quiet once more. Do you know what that means?
Basta lavorare.
Si passa tutto il giorno a bere.
E a puttane.
What? It's true.
Come, Ezio. Walk with me.
Yes, uncle.
Okay.
The Pazzi answer to another. Spaniard.
He is Rodrigo Borgia, one of the most powerful men in all of Europe, and leader of the Templar Order.
I will kill him.
Which makes him responsible for the murder of my father and brothers.
Yes, and he will kill you too, given the chance.
Then I must stand against him if I wish to be free. But not until every other Templar has fallen to my blade. Father's list will guide me.
Where will you go next?
Firenze. Francesco de Pazzi will share the fate of his son.
A sensible next step. No doubt he intends evil for the city. All right, that's enough grim talk for one night. I'll be in my study if you need me.
I shall read the letter my uncle gave me.
Okay.
Messer Francesco, I have done as requested and spoken with your son. I agree with your assessment, though only in part. Yes, Vieri is brash and prone to act without forethought. And he has a habit of treating the mercenari like playthings. I have received reports of at least three men being disfigured as a result. But I do not think him, as you put it, beyond repair. Rather, I believe the solution to be a simple matter. He seeks your approval, your attention. These outbursts of his are a result of insecurities born out of a sense of inadequacy. He speaks of you often and fondly, and expresses a desire to be closer to you. So, if he is loud and foul and angry, I believe it is simply because he wants to be noticed. He wants to be loved. Act as you see fit on the information I've given you here. But I must ask that we end this correspondence. Were he to discover the nature of our conversations, I fear what might become of me. Yours in confidence, Fra Giocondo.
New guy. I read the letter.
Look familiar?
Other codex pages.
Yes. Your father managed to find and translate a few before he...
Here.
This is not your father's work. Someone else has translated it.
Leonardo da Vinci, a friend.
Do you see the way the words cross from one page to the next?
There is something underneath it all. Some kind of map. Where is it supposed to lead?
Your father and I managed to make out bits of a prophecy scrawled across these pages. It was written by an assassin like us, who long ago held a piece of Eden. His name was Altair. He spoke of something powerful and ancient hidden beneath the land.
What is it?
What indeed? Solving that little mystery is exactly why we collected these pages.
Then let me help. It's time I take on my father's work. All of it. I start with the page I took from Vieri. Leonardo will decode it for us.
Bene. Return here when time permits, and we'll add it to the wall.
And I'm off to the roof. Because the roof is my friend. So, yeah, with this,
I believe that the country is beautiful. Yay, finding things. Well, they're not that well hidden. Shiny golden boxes. Okay, next. It's a drunken wager. We all like drunken wagers. Especially when it includes free running. All the free running in the world is no better than this. Than me on this. Run. Left. Alright. Left. I see another one. Shiny golden box. Well hidden. Okay. Sorry, just need to check the map. Where is it? It's all the way over there.
Why would anyone carry on like that?
Because I'm an assassin. Deal with it. Oh, that was sweet. Riding. That was so beautiful. Why would you keep things in beautiful golden boxes? I'm going home. I'm coming home. Tell the world that I'm coming home. Watch the rain yesterday. I know my kingdom's away. I'm coming home. Coming home. Tell the world I'm coming home. Come on. Oh, hello. Easy way of getting back. Huh.
Salute, Claudia.
Our uncle is un mostro. This is outrageous.
What's happened?
He's making me work. If Father was here, I'd never be stuck behind a desk like this.
And what are the terms of this supposed enslavement?
Since someone decided we're going to stay here, Tio Mario suggested we try and find the money to repair the villa. Problem is, there isn't any.
I bet I can bring in some money.
Oh, great. More work for me. Well, benissimo. If you start paying for improvements to the town, I'll keep track of them in this book. And since I have nothing better to do, I'll also make note of any objects you bring in from the outside. If you actually get this place up and running, travelers might visit and spend money. Although I doubt anyone will want to come this far out of the city. But if they do, I'll keep the money we make in this chest. You're going to have to show up to take it to the bank yourself. Because when it gets full, I'm just going to take the extra cash for myself. Capito?
Dio.
Hai capito?
Buongiorno. Is there something wrong?
Yes, Sir Mario hired me to deal with this mess, but I'm an architetto, not a miracle worker. Without money, I can't fix any of these buildings.
And if someone brought you money?
Then we'd be in business. You must be Ser Ezio. Am I right?
You are not wrong.
Uncle, I like this architetto.
He gets very observant when he can smell money.
If you want to fix up this town, I'm going to need it. I have a price list here for new shops and renovations. Just bring me gold, make a choice, and I'll begin at once.
Okay.
If I build you a shop, you, as the landlord, can purchase goods there at lower rates. If you invest more money in the shop, you get an even greater discount. As for renovations, well, you'll be bringing the town and villa back to life. As Sir Mario tells me, that was very important to your great-great-grandfather. Plus, when you buy shops and renovations, you'll be increasing the number of people who visit, causing your income to increase. So, let's take a look, shall we?
Okay. We have a bank. And because I'm a man, I'm going to build a brothel. Oh, and a thieves guild, because who doesn't like thieves? Okay.
Buon viaggio!
I think that's everything. Okay, so yeah, I'm going to leave it there. We are now in Montenegrione, and we've killed our first Templar. So I would say it's time to say goodbye. So, goodbye and peace out.